Hi! Time to test some record-setting infrared lasers from a rainbow of lasers. One of them has a surprisingly common color. You likely have had several of them without realizing it. Others will turn out to have surprising output powers, both in great and disappointing ways, demonstrating why the sky is blue and the sunset is red. And one of them has something I have never seen before, a weird deca beam. Guess how strong this 10-in-1 laser beam is. When experimenting with a laser, wear safety glasses suitable for its wavelength and power output, especially for invisible infrared lasers. After filling some gaps and even expanding into ultraviolet in my previous video, I have some dark holes to fill in the infrared region. This 780 nanometers infrared should fit between my 670 and 808 nanometers lasers. If it is 780 nanometers infrared, I can clearly see the deep red dot from it. Let's check it on the spectrometer. (783 nanometers). Great! This is the first 780 laser I have measured. Though, admittedly, it is not my first 780 laser. Not even close. 780 nanometers used to be, and likely still is, by far the most common laser color. My first one goes so far back that I can't even remember it. I am, however, sure my first battery-operated 780 nanometers laser was this one. A portable CD player. Yep, infrared 780 nanometers lasers are used to read CDs. This one still works just fine. If I switch my camera to night shot mode, where its infrared filter is removed, we can clearly see the happy little dancing lens being lit up by the laser. It does not take much laser light to just read a CD, though its class 1 rating only applies when the laser light is trapped inside the player. When the safety interlock is bypassed, which you obviously shouldn't, the reading laser beam is likely a class 2 or even class 3R before the lens. Plenty enough to measure its wavelength, even though the beam quickly thins out after the focal point just above the lens where the CD should be. Is it 780 nanometers as all online sources claim? Close enough, 789 nanometers. Lasers with shorter wavelengths, like the violet 405 nanometers lasers for Blu-ray discs, give higher data capacity. Why? Well, the answer is hidden in a real rainbow and in an old video of mine. Now, stronger 780 nanometers lasers are used in CD writers, where they literally have to burn a track onto a CD. These can typically output between 50 to 125 milliwatts, even higher when pulsed, blinking for writing a digital track. This one is advertised at 100 milliwatts, within the CV rating for a CD burning laser. Let's test how much it really is. Oh, 50 milliwatts after warming up for a while. Half of the advertised. That's a bit disappointing. I likely have a stronger diode in one of my CD writers. Hope this next one is a lot stronger, since I bought it to dethrone my strongest 980 nanometers laser. This 980T500 could potentially be up to 500 milliwatts, much stronger than my 109 milliwatts 980T150. Measuring its wavelength first. Oh, that's not 980 nanometers. This is an outlier 980 diode, lasering at 970, almost 969 nanometers. I'd say this is not just replacing my other 980 nanometers laser. It qualifies as a new wavelength altogether in my collection. Nice. Is it 500 milliwatts as its model number implies? Nope, I am not having much luck with these eBay infrared lasers. Still, at 324 milliwatts, it is by far my strongest infrared laser. Almost twice as strong as the nearest competitor, the 178 milliwatts 808 nanometers. Not bad. However, likely not a record for long. The next laser should fill the large gap between 808 and 970 nanometers and perhaps be three times stronger than the brand new record holder. It is advertised as an 850 nanometers laser with an output power of 1000 milliwatts. Maybe my first class 4 infrared laser. Well, given the other eBay infrared lasers I've tested, I doubt it will be as strong as advertised. I asked my patrons what power they would expect from it. For some reason, most seem to believe it will be more than 1000 milliwatts. Despite being only half the price of the 320 milliwatts 970 nanometers. I will test it right after this short but important message. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. Your help with getting the laser pyrometer and spectrometer makes videos like this one possible. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. Alright, will this laser even turn on? Yes, good sign. The camera is picking up some infrared, even through its infrared filter. This camera records infrared as violet or purple. Likely because its biofilter lets most infrared pass through to the pixels recording red and blue, less to the ones recording green. Red and blue mix to purple. Is this infrared 850 nanometers? Not quite. More or less another outlier diode at 859 nanometers. These infrared laser diodes are not the most accurate. Or the outliers are sold cheaply for eBay lasers. Makes me worry about its true output power. A full 1 watt seems optimistic for an inexpensive laser module. Does it look bright with the infrared filter removed? Wow, that is some serious lens reflection. Maybe this laser is powerful enough after all to have a noticeable beam in untreated air in night shot mode. I tried in several setups, but even in the best shot, the beam is barely noticeable. Shouldn't a 1 watt beam be more visible? Time to find out how strong this laser is. Am I seeing this right? Am I doing this right? Second try. My patrons were right. This is above 1000 milliwatts, 20% above advertised, at 1200 milliwatts. I finally have a class 4 infrared laser, at a cost of less than 3 cents per milliwatt. What's the catch? And why is this very strong 1.2 watt beam not more visible to the camera? Well, longer wavelengths, like red and infrared, easily pass through air with little scattering. While shorter wavelengths, like blue and violet, are easily scattered in another direction. That's why a sunset is red. Of the visible light from the sun, only red and infrared can easily pass straight through a longer stretch of air. And the sky looks blue because the blue and violet light from the sun is scattered more easily away from its direct path by the air. Actually, the sky would look more indigo or even violet if our eyes were more sensitive to these colors. This scattering effect is called Rayleigh scattering. Since the infrared from this laser easily passes straight through air, very little of the infrared light is scattered into the camera seen from the side or behind. The laser just has the wrong, too long wavelength to be noticed from the side in pure air. Another reason for its low visibility to the camera is how the 1.2 watts of energy is not packed into one tight and intense beam. You may have noticed the beam is quite wide. And if I focus the beam, it turns out to be not just one single beam of light. This laser sends out 10 beams, a deca beam. I have never seen this before and struggled to explain it. My first reaction was, it is a high-powered transverse multimode diode with low beam quality. But I've never heard of a TEM90 or TEM09 diode. And there's an unusual spacing in the middle. To me, it looks more like a multi-emitter diode with 10 emitters in two groups of 5. Does such a diode exist in this small form factor? Help me out in the comments with any info and input you might have. This laser turned out to be way more interesting than I thought it would be. Click like if you agree and consider subscribing for more. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.